RET fusions are rare in lung cancer, but they're rare like ROS fusions, which are an established subpopulation that we find and we know can be very targetable. They're less common than ALK. I would say they're 1 to 2% of lung cancer, more common in adenocarcinomas or never light smokers, but they can be seen in former smokers as well. They are on our standard panels. They're on our targeted NGS panels. You get these results in clinic if you keep your eyes peeled. And so it's important to keep an eye out for them. And just like ALK and ROS, RET needs to be on there as a group that can be targeted effectively. It's worth knowing that the liquid biopsy technologies we're sending these days to look for targetable mutations, I think they aren't quite as good at fusions yet. And so remember, if your liquid biopsy is negative, you still should always fall back on a tumor testing as a more definitive way to look for this. But certainly when it does show up, get these patients to studies because they can work.